I suspect that, you know, entrepreneurship is something that you have to just give a try. And if you really want to be entrepreneurial, then you just have to get up and do it one morning. But there are both educational as well as structural problems to entrepreneurship in this country. And we've heard a variety of people from government and quasi-government talk about it, about the problems from or the efforts they're making on their side. And we've heard of the whining about educational institutions not being designed to create entrepreneurship. But I think that given that all of you are working within a broader framework of AICTE and its attendant benefits and responsibilities, the fact is to recognize that entrepreneurship requires essentially, as speaker after speaker has said, first, a set of skills which are already embedded in the person, in that student, at some stage in their educational qualifications and life, if they're going to actually make an attempt to do something which is useful. And the purpose of education, as I see it, is only twofold. One is to ensure that you can seat yourself down and do one thing repeatedly, day after day, when it's necessary. And the second thing is to build up a set of basic skills in communications, in working with teams and people, and in being able to understand the rules of how this economy works in terms of taxation, in terms of labor laws, etc. So once education has achieved that, by the age of 18, 20, and some people earlier, the job of education is really done. Once you create the experience and the practice of being able to work hard, to live according to a schedule, to be punctual, all these life skills, which are, to my mind, essentially taught either at school or in early college and can't be taught thereafter. Once you've got basic grammar right in school, after that, you are good enough to be an entrepreneur. So what do educational institutions need to do? Besides the great ideas of setting up entrepreneurial cells as part of your placement cells, and I think these are all nomenclature games, the good news is that of the top 100 management institutes in the country, in the last year, in 2013, 1,000 people opted out of conventional placements to opt for joining a startup or starting a startup themselves. That to me is the good news. The good news is that 1,000 of the students from the 100 top institutions decided not to go for placement. And those numbers, in my view, are likely to increase. Is there a cycle by which entrepreneurship flows? Is it higher during the good years, during the Hindu growth years, or is it higher during the gung-ho, busting, high growth years? In my sense and my experience, high growth periods are when young people feel it's worth indulging in their enthusiasm for entrepreneurship to go out and try their hand at it. So entrepreneurship also follows a certain kind of time scale. What can educational institutions do to help entrepreneurship? The first thing is, once you've tested your students on these basic life skills, given them the additional skills that they need to cope and manage in the cruel world of entrepreneurship, where failure is highly likely, the first thing that they can do is get out of the way. And how do they get out of the way? By ensuring that in terms of giving them some kind of ranking, and the world, unfortunately, where you have scarcity of resources is about ranking them on things other than scholastic mark sheets, which seems to be the basis of and the bedrock of our educational system. So you need to find other measures and give kids, students, a chance to understand what their life skill sets are in terms of ranking to be able to cope with anything that they want to try their hand at in the future. The last speaker spoke about scale, and that is where I think the real challenge of entrepreneurship comes. But I'm not going to go into that. From a government point of view, what are the two things that need to be done to allow for entrepreneurship to bloom and blossom? I think the first thing is that we need to get rid of the fear of failure. Failure is very expensive in India. You try closing down a company and you realize you pay a chartered accountant large sums of money, plus a lot of people a lot of money to close down an operation. So failing is very expensive in India, and you've got to make failing cheap. You've got to be able to allow easy exit, and that is one of the fundamental legal problems which government needs to sort out if it is serious about entrepreneurship. Unfortunately, there is no choice about being serious about entrepreneurship, which is my second point. Going by the statistics we have at the moment, India is not going to be, in the next 10 or 20 years, be able to provide employment for the majority of the people who are, in inverted commas, eligible for employment. So the creation of giant new enterprises is an absolute necessity if India is to avoid social hell. So as far as government is concerned, it needs to hear the fact that in the coming days, unless we create risk-taking capability in enterprises which are willing to take the chance and willing to take the risk of being closed down, the opportunity to hire people, we are going to be stuck in a situation where we will simply be unable to employ the large number of students that all of you are churning out with expectations, educational qualifications, and unfortunately, a set of aspirations which are fed by the media and by their own safety net of parents who are capable of looking after themselves and preventing them from being on the streets. So the future could be good. The future could be great. The idea is unleash entrepreneurship. Make sure that educational institutions find other ways of ranking their students to make them acceptable to angels, to make them willing to take the risk, and to give them the time to fly. And government needs to move out of the way, remove the safety nets which have been created to so-called prevent misuse, but actually allow enterprises to fail, and then we have enough of an entrepreneurial incubation atmosphere to create the next generation of enterprises, which is the only salvation for this country. Thank you.